All right, let's take a look at the latest on Hurricane Delta. As I mentioned at the top of the hour, the winds are a little bit higher at 120 miles an hour. Pressure has been, they dropped earlier, but have been holding steady. And that forward motion, at least the speed has not really increased as of yet. That will likely occur tomorrow, but the motion has been more north than northwest. And just tracking the eye itself and looking at the center of the storm, it has definitely been more north than northwest at all. You can actually kind of use the lines of longitude to follow that along. So it has been moving north, which is expected. It's strengthening, which was also expected. And the intensification, though it has a brief window to continue to expand in strength or increase in strength, I should say, that window is going to be closing very soon. Probably by tomorrow morning, we're going to see an influx of wind shear increasing, dry air, and cooler surface water temperatures, which will all help to first stop the strengthening and then start weakening as it moves toward the coast. So the Hurricane Center does have it as a 3 down to a 2 very quickly right near landfall. There's always that question as to what these storms do in proximity of land, because that interaction will usually start to interrupt and disrupt the circulation, but also water temperatures along the Gulf Coast of Louisiana, Texas are much cooler and in the 70s, and the storms cannot maintain their strength in that. So hopefully we will see it weakening before landfall. We will, but it'd be nice if it got even lower than a category 2. But notice it will continue and quickly weaken as it moves inland, and all of the rainfall associated by the time it's already north of us in North Mississippi will be clear of the rain and actually improving conditions by the middle part of the day on Saturday. As I mentioned, models, you're not going to see really any other changes other than maybe a little jog one way or another from west to east. But basically, we are looking at southwest Louisiana landfall, which again is right at about where Laura made landfall about 6 weeks ago. Just so incredible for them. Hopefully this is not a major hurricane at landfall. Again, I'm always looking for that silver lining. Also notice, as the models are in better agreement, where all of the heavy rainfall is. We really haven't seen that too frequently with a lot of these landfalling systems. They tend to start spreading out all that heavy rainfall well away from the center. Remember Marco? Now obviously this is not the same situation, but Marco was so disrupted. We had the landfall of the center near the mouth of the river, and most of the thunderstorm development was over toward Panama City. That is not the case with this. All of the heavy rain is going to be right near the center, so that's where we see the swath of the heavier rainfall. As you get just to the east or to the west, those rainfall totals come way, way down. Now we're still going to see some rainfall and a few bands of some heavier downpours and also the risk of some tornadic storms, but in terms of high accumulations that would lead to flooding, that is just not going to be the case. Also, we have seen some adjustment to the wind field expectation. So these are the tropical storm force winds, those in yellow. Certainly lower Terrebonne could see some parts of the river parishes, but notice no longer do we really see much of the metro area at all under the potential of those tropical storm force winds. Maybe gusts up over 40 miles an hour, but I don't think we're really going to see sustained winds quite that high. Storm surge also a threat. 2 to 4 feet is expected across most of our coast, east of the mouth of the river, west 3 to 5 feet to Port Fouchon, and then west of Port Fouchon around 4 to 7. Tomorrow we are under a slight risk of severe weather. Again, these landfalling storms, we're going to be in the northeastern quadrant, and any of these little cells that kind of rotate through or any of the bands could produce some tornadic storms. They usually are pretty brief. They don't last for very long. They tend to be a little bit on the weaker side, and that may be something we have to watch for. Also, if you look at the radar model, we're not looking at just a constant all-day rain. We will see plenty of breaks in the rainfall as well. Dry air over Texas as the upper trough continues to sweep on in. That's going to, one, start picking up that forward speed of Delta, as well as begin wrapping that dry air around. And as that dry air wraps around, we see most of the moisture really kind of become more compact near the center, which is why we are not anticipating really any heavy rainfall around us. The storm has gotten much larger, already starting to see some of the heavier rain move northward. But folks in Texas, as a matter of fact, may see some heavier rainfall than we will, and they're on the drier side. Heavy rains already somewhat associated with all the moisture. North of the Baton Rouge area, some street flood advisories out for them. Most of the North Shore of Mississippi, where we had a lot of our rainfall today, a lot of that is now winding down.